It is Captain Boomer. I'm coming right at you, live from the beautiful Twin Cities area. Yes, and boy, I'm telling you, hey, today's show is entitled "Old and Expendable?" Question mark. Yeah, I don't know about you guys, but man, I'm telling you, and I told this to the wife months ago when this stuff even started, and I've been preaching on this with my, of course, no one listens to this crap anyway, but if you are happening to be listening, thank you, and I just do some venting, and I try to, in my own way, try to set things kind of, straight, kind of, I'm not going to pull, I don't pull any punches, I don't, I'm too old. Anyway, but here's the deal. The deal is this. I just heard on the news, now see there again, how much of the news can we believe these days, Because there's so many gray areas out there now. is anything legitimate anymore? I mean, I'm beginning to wonder. Sure as hell, though, that politics isn't, on the up and up. You got the sports, you got entertainment, you got politics, you got, and I don't know of one group that you can really rely on that's actually spilling out the truth. Because it's a lot of times the truth has got to be twisted for our own gains. And boy, I tell you, there's a lot of people out there making millions of dollars with bullshit. Let's face it. Anyway. What I'm getting at is this. I heard this morning, just maybe a half hour ago, 45 minutes ago, on the news, take it with a grain of salt, that supposedly the vaccines, and me and the wife, and millions of my brother and brethren and sister and boomers out there, if me and the wife got our shots, I'm about expired in more ways than one. Because my last shot is probably my second shot, which is the last shot. A Pfizer did now that kind of expired here in about another 2 weeks. It's going to be not 100% expired, but its protective percentage has gone down a lot, okay. And supposedly we were going to get a booster. And I got my shots at the VA. And boy, I'm telling you, I don't know if I'm going to depend on those guys to let me know if they're going to have this booster. Anyways, from what I heard, trying to make them short if I can, that supposedly they're going to be having, they're not going to be giving us older farts this booster from Pfizer because they're thinking about. Now, you're sitting down? I hope you are, because, they're thinking about our beautiful government with sleepy-eyed Joey in there now. They said something about they're going to be sending millions and millions of doses to foreign countries. Yes, before us seniors and boomers, we get our final booster shot. I don't know how you feel about it, but I'll tell you what. I'm pissed. How about you, Bob?
Hell yeah!
Yeah, hell yeah is right. Yeah. So there you have it. Well, I've been screwed over by the government so many times. Oh, God, yeah. Yeah, it started all, you know, back with my brother in Vietnam. Got screwed there. We got sprayed and betrayed. We got lied to. We got spit on. We got shit on. We got all sorts of stuff. And now in my 70s, now I just entered my 70s. I should be taking it easy, not worried about stuff. But now this, you know, for us boomers, this crap is coming up. And I'm telling you. Woo-hoo! Man, I'm telling you. It's, I don't know where to begin. It's, yeah, yep. That's one way to describe it. So, once again, I kind of got off on a semi-tear. I don't know. Something stinks in Denmark big time. And I'm telling you, it's... I've been saying this for a while now. We take 3 steps forward and 5 steps backwards. First, they say the shots are doing really good and you don't need a booster. Then they come out and, oh, you need a booster. Now they say, well, we're going to do you one better. Not only are we not going to give you your booster shot, you senior bastards, we're going to send those ones meant for you. We're going to send a first round, spend money and stuff, and send a whole millions and millions of doses over to countries that need them. Hello, something wrong. Oh my God, you know, yeah. I need the help me guy here. What do you think, help me guy? We definitely need some help, right? Where is my buddy? Yes. Help me. You should get a change to help us. Help us. Yeah, I don't know. Well, there's one thing about what's going on in the world today, man. There's a whole lot of juicy shit to talk about, that's for sure. Most of it ain't good, that's the hell of it. That's right. But anyways, we're gonna move on here, and I'm gonna liven you guys up, and you're gonna have some fun here, and, well, I hope anyway. Let's see what we got here. It can be fun. Okay? It can be fun. Let's see, where are we going here? Well, that ain't right. Well, maybe this one. Hang on, guys. Are you ready? All right. That ain't it, big dummy. You big dummy. I'm getting there. At least I think I am. Hang on. Hang on. Here we go. Shots overseas, we don't even care. We're old and gray and we're losing our hair. Hey, don't give them to us, we don't really want them. Hey, send them overseas, cause they ain't got them. Yeah, we're expendable, baby. Won't be out there dancing much longer, huh? Yeah, they want all us old bastards to be dead. You betcha. That's the only thing I can figure out. God bless you, Olena. I love ya. Later, guys. Alrighty then. Here we go. There we go. Thank you. That's Ole and Lena. They are still out there two-stepping. You betcha. Yeah. And they didn't like that news either. I can't imagine any boomer, any boomer, or even older than us boomers, welcoming that kind of news. I'm telling you. What the hell is Sleepy Joe thinking? let's see. The older people cost more money to take care of than probably the younger people. Yeah, there's something in there for sure. You know, there's a gray area. You know, like I told you before, I don't know if you ever saw the movie, guys. It was called Soylent Green. That's where, and we're heading there, kind of, in a way. I mean, look at the planet, the weather, the drought, the floods. I mean, it's all put together. I can only imagine what this winter might be like. Oh my God, who knows? Anyways, that's what it's like. It's like these movies. I mean, it's like real life, these movies. I mean, it's not good. Let's put it that way. Anywho, thank God I still got my sanity. Yeah, you ain't gonna mess with my sanity. I'm all intact here. You betcha. Yeah, and I got my blow up dolls to keep me company. You betcha. I got a new blonde one coming next week. She's gonna be a honey. You betcha. Blow up dolls, here they come. All right. At least I won't go out lonely. Whatever. I don't have to worry about the wife listening. She hasn't listened to one of my shows. She's not a damn one. I guess I don't blame her in a way. But anyway, I got to get some fresher coffee here, guys. So we're going to go on to... I got to kill some time. And so you guys can listen to my brother Bruce and his song called Mystery Train.
Had been shifted, and I knew that I was in some fantasy.